Broadcasting from the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia to around the globe. You're listening to Shark Bite Biz, your exclusive place for business strategy, sales, marketing, and tech in the roaring 20s. And now, here's your host, David Strausser.
And welcome to another edition of Shark Bite Biz. I'm your fabulous host, David Strausser, and it is time to unlock your mind. Why? Well, because we have so much going on right now that it is an extremely difficult environment to be able to sell and close deals in. It's difficult to really understand your customer and to even communicate with them because, like most people, they are stressed the heck out. They're working from home, juggling family life. Maybe they have to be a teacher to their kids. Everybody, personal, work life, extremely stressful situations. That's why today's guest is a true expert to help you unlock your mind and think about things differently. In fact, NLP, which, excuse me, but I actually have to read this word from the screen, neuro-linguistic programming, I am so bad at saying that itself, I chop it up every time, but NLP has a ton of similarities that all the sales execs out there, you're probably going to recognize this. As I was discussing this with our guest, I'm like, wow, this sounds just like I manage a sales cycle. And it is. You should instantly be able to recognize this. It's a very similar approach to how not only you handle sales, but honestly, you should handle life using NLP. From people like Tony Robbins to a lot of other people out there, it's something that helps a lot of people in business succeed. So yeah, I probably oversimplified it a little bit about what NLP is, but our next guest is going to give you some amazing information on what it is and how it will help you. Again, for me, through using NLP from a sales cycle to personal life, to just managing my clients, my employees, everything, it is really just allowing me to not only achieve my goals, but it's allowing me to both professionally and personally excel at life. I mean, it's a pretty amazing thing that we have going on here with NLP, but you need to really understand, what is it? How can it help me? How can I learn this? And I think you'll be surprised to hear about how many people actually use NLP without even realizing that they are using NLP. Today's guest is going to be a memorable one. She always makes an impression, and she is also known as the Shiny One. Shiny Burcu Unsal is the global award-winning creator of NeuroShine technology, a licensed trainer of neuro-linguistic programming, an ICF certified executive coach, at Forbes Coaches Council, an ICF accredited professional coach trainer, and a top rated professor at UCLA Extension, teaching leadership, communication strategies, and emotional intelligence since back in 2012. Without further ado, let's welcome the Shiny One.
Make the sale.
Hi, Shiny. Welcome to the show. We're so glad to have you on Shark Bite Biz. Welcome.
Well, thanks for having me, David. I am looking forward to having an amazing conversation with you.
Oh, that's great. Well, let's kick it off. Well, talking about you. What makes Shiny shiny? Tell us a little bit about you.
Well, actually, what makes Shiny shiny is her life purpose. I was not shiny all the time. I became shiny in 2015 when I became a United States, a proud American United States citizen. And the reason I named myself Shiny is because it represents the enlightenment of the mind.
Right.
And this brilliance, the wisdom, the cosmic brilliance of the heart. So I believe in integrations. I believe in combinations. I love math. I love logic. And at the same time, I also love magic. So I created my methodology. It's called NeuroShine Technology.
Yeah.
It combines the power of the mind with the wisdom of the heart. And it helps us to make decisions and live life from the truth of who we are. And NeuroShine Technology is just that. I am a coach trainer. I am an NLP trainer. I have been having my training and coaching company since 2011. And I created this methodology to, you know, make a greater impact in the world and to help them get closer to their truth. So I'm sure you can relate to that, right? I
mean, oh, definitely.
I don't know how you grew up, but I grew up with a lot of conditions. Have you?
Oh, yeah, definitely, definitely. Totally can relate to that. But let me ask you, here's an off-the-ball question. Shiny, that's not show name. That's your actual real name, right?
It is my actual real name, and thanks for asking, because a lot of people think that it might be my nickname. No, it's on my passport. Shiny Burcu Unsal is my legal name. And I represent the enlightenment of the mind. And let me just give you a little bit more information about myself, because that might give a more grounded.
Yeah, definitely. Give us some background.
Yeah. So I grew up in Turkey, and I studied at the MIT of Turkey, and I went to UCLA, and I went to Harvard, and I also studied metaphysical psychology and at the University of Metaphysics. And today, I am actually at the faculty of the University of California in Los Angeles,
yes.
UCLA Extension. I've been teaching leadership communication strategies and emotional intelligence since 2012. And I am also a proud member of the Forbes Coaches Council. I get to write for Forbes. And I am an ICF certified executive coach. And also, my trainings are fully approved by ICF. And for the ones who don't know anything about ICF, it stands for International Coaching Federation.
Yeah.
Because the coaching industry is not regulated, ICF takes care of that and regulates the whole industry globally and just like gives us a like higher standards and
right.
to become a world-class coach to help people make to help the world a better place.
Right. You know, out of all of that, what you just said, there's a couple key points that I got here. Let me just break it down. You are an author, you are a professor, and you are the master of the mind.
Yeah. I would love to be. I'm still on my progress. I'm on my way.
You're on your way. Well, to me, and I think to most folks, they'll probably view you as a master, because it's with these NLP techniques that you use that really allows people to advance their cause in business. So let's take a step back. For many listeners and viewers on YouTube, NLP might be a new concept for them. Can you give us a 10,000 foot view? Just give us a summary. What is NLP and why should it be important to them?
NLP stands for Neuro-Linguistic Programming. It is a methodology to study neuro, which is the nervous system. Mm-hmm. It teaches us how we think, how the mind creates the meaning. You know, the brain is a meaning-making machine. So you learn the specifics about that with the neuro part of it.
Mm-hmm.
Linguistics is a representation of the language.
Right.
Verbal and nonverbal language, because language dictates reality.
Yeah.
The way we speak about ourselves and others, it creates this programming part.
Mm-hmm.
Programming represents the behaviors, because we are, as I mentioned before, we are conditioned. There is a ton of conditioning in the mind, so sometimes we don't have the beliefs. We don't own the beliefs that we grew up with. And if they still show up in everyday world, it can create problems. Why is it important? Because if you don't understand your own system, your own brain, and how it works and how it creates thought, how it creates language, how it creates behavior. If you don't understand that, like you don't know how to use the machine, there is no way for you to reverse engineer, you know? And I have been in the corporate world before I started my own business for a decade. So in that corporate world, I had my own problems. I felt like nobody cared about me, nobody knew about me, and nobody really understood me. Because most of the time, we really, do you know what we do, David? We tend to communicate from the tip of the iceberg to the tip of the iceberg. What is truly going on is underneath the iceberg. And NLP helps us to do just that. When you learn NLP, you get to listen to what people are not saying.
Right.
When you learn NLP, you get to understand what one word can mean a whole world for one person. And you learn to understand and appreciate their world instead of arguing, no, you're wrong. No, that's not how it's supposed to be. You know, we have to do it this way. You change the way you talk, you change the way you show up, and you give people the freedom to be. And that's why NLP is crucial. It's important. And you said it might be new for a lot of people, but it's not. It's like half a decade, half a century old. Like it's coming from 1970s.
Wow.
Like
so
it's been out there for half a century.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Can you name some? I know there's a lot of people, all different skill sets, but give us an idea, professionally speaking, big names, like some people that actually live and use NLP practices.
Well, that's a good question.
Yeah.
I want to start with Tony Robbins.
I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah, of course, right?
Yes.
Because Tony Robbins actually made NLP NLP because when he learned it from the founders, Dr. Richard Bandler and John Grinder, when he learned NLP, there was no coaching world yet. There was nothing about personal growth the way we know it today.
Right.
So he created this whole concept of coaching because he implied NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, and Oprah. I mean,
Oprah.
NLP's, yeah.
That surprised me.
I know. Why do I say Oprah? Because NLP is not an academic field. It's not something that you learn to study something new. NLP is a methodology of what we already do. Does that make sense? So if you actually interview Dr. Richard Bandler, the founder of NLP, he's going to tell you exactly that. He's going to tell you, hey, you know what? I never aimed to create NLP as an academic field. It's already something that we do as humans. I wanted to put it all together. And that's why I'm giving Oprah as an example, even though she is not NLP certified, NLP trained, or anything like that. But the way she thinks, the way she operates, the way she lives her life, and the way she creates success is a true example of how neurolinguistic programming shows up in somebody's life. Another example who studied NLP and then who actually, you know, created magic in their life is me.
Exactly. Probably the most famous of them all, right?
Totally. You gotta know the shiny one, right?
Right.
Real. I studied NLP. I learned the power of my mind. I learned the language, how crazy it is that we are programmed with words.
Yep.
And I implemented it. And I was this executive in Turkey, in Istanbul, Turkey. Now I chase my dreams and now I have my own little empire, my training and coaching business, and I change lives, and that's how
and
I
your
make
events.
Money and impact. I love it.
I've seen your training events, the videos. For those who don't really know me or Shiny, we've been friends for a couple years, and I see constantly you get a lot of attendance at your classes and the people that sign up, and the reviews I hear is that it's life-changing to a lot of them because they're able to look at the world and deal with the world through a new set of glasses.
Totally. And themselves.
I mean,
like, we all study with ourselves. Like, who are you? What makes you you? What kind of beliefs, values you operate with? When you go to work, the same brain goes to work.
Right,
with the beliefs,
right.
Set of values, judgments, and filters. And that affects the way you look at a project. That affects the way you talk to your colleagues. That affects the way you come up with ideas. And the same brain goes to work. And you got to understand what's in it. Right?
Yeah, definitely. I'm sorry. I'm still giggling a little bit because I just realized I asked you for some famous people that are using it and you lumped yourself with Tony Robbins and Oprah. It cracked me up when you were speaking. So one of the things that has, you know, attracted me to NLP is as I've been learning about the topic, the subject, how you teach things, is, you know, I really realize, like, man, I already do a lot of these things just from being in sales. It's basically a more structured, formalized practice, and I think that has a lot of value for people in business.
Totally. Sales is an area you will absolutely need to study NLP, because when you study NLP, like we said, you study yourself and how you do life. And why is it useful in sales? Because once you understand how the mind works, how people make decisions, and how they justify it later on. I mean, as you know, in sales, you know, we make emotional decisions and then we justify it logically, right?
Right.
So once you understand the mechanics behind it, once you are able to tap into what is the most important part of that decision-making process, then look at sales. So some people look at sales and then they feel like, oh, you know, it's just like they're trying to get my money. No. The way you look at sales is what runs the world.
Right.
Sales is what creates real impact. Mm-hmm. Without sales, there are no companies, no corporations, no economy. Forget it, right? So sales is how you can make a difference, literally.
Yeah,
and
it
for
is.
That, you got to know the person that you are talking to. And NLP is going to teach you how you can listen to them with the nonverbals, how you can build rapport with them, and how you can bypass the resistance of their primitive parts of the brain. That's kind of like my NLP, actually, because I also blend it with neuroscience, and I teach them about the amygdala, because, you know, that's the fight or flight response in the brain. And if you are not able to regulate your language in a way to make it like round and vague and in a way hypnotic in NLP language, if you're not able to do that, you will trigger people and you won't get the result that you want. You won't make the sales.
There's a lot of triggered people around anymore.
Oh,
it's
crazy.
And I think NLP definitely will help you with that so that you get the right words out, I believe. Because you know the person you're talking to, and using the NLP methods, that should help you avoid triggering the person you're trying to sell.
Exactly. And that's exactly what I am referring to. So if, like, let's just take a case study or a scenario. You're in sales and then there is a client in front of you and that person does not like golfing. Okay.
Yep.
Actually, he has a thing with golfing. He just doesn't enjoy it. He thinks that it's stupid. Okay. So if you go into the conversation of golfing and if you try to convince the person, oh, no, you don't understand. Golfing is actually really fun. Maybe you just haven't tried it in a beautiful way. And he keeps saying, no, I don't like it. It's stupid. And then you still want to try to win him over. You're trying to convince. That's not the way it is. You're going to trigger this man. And you're gonna make this person defend himself and defend is an interesting neurology and neuropsychology, because in order for you to defend, amygdala needs to be triggered. Once amygdala is triggered, there's a whole parts of other parts of the brain. They're going to all get together. They're going to open up the other mental files, maybe even from their childhood, why they have to always defend themselves. Okay, right. It's going to go to mommy, daddy issues. It's going to go to seriously.
So let's look at the current situation. You know, we're half in, half out lockdowns. It's a weird thing. Who knows where they're going to be going the next couple of weeks. How much more valuable is the NLP going to be be able to reach customers, because everything is different. The way that we're doing business in July is different than what we were doing back in February.
That's true. Yeah.
So how does having those keys going to help you unlock more sales with the current lockdown situation?
What I am going to say is going to start with understanding.
Okay.
Human psychology requires basic things. We want to be heard. Mm-hmm. We want to be seen. We want to be appreciated. But they're not going to mean anything unless we are safe. So, safety first, okay? Mm-hmm. When people feel safe with you, then you gotta give them feeling seen, heard, and appreciated. And that's why there is a whole structured language that you can use with NLP. Mm-hmm. And especially during these times, what people are feeling is uncertainty, right. Anxiety,
yeah.
Fear, unknown. This shakiness, it's just not very, you know, rosy, shiny, right. Happy feelings, obviously. And that's where we need to begin with. We need to begin with understanding where we are.
Right.
And give it to people. I understand your concern.
Yeah.
This is what's going on. And let's look at solutions by integrating this concern into the future, because there is always this future vision that pulls humanity into it, right?
Okay.
If you don't have that future consciousness, because I mean, everybody has this, but we sometimes forget.
Okay.
If you tend to live in the past, even your past is a good past, it's not going to serve you in terms of like excitement and all this like motivation towards the future.
Right.
So NLP is going to help someone to remember that. Okay, we need a very compelling future vision. Mm-hmm. And that vision needs to be designed in such a way that's going to help both the pull and the push effect, the pain and pleasure.
Right.
And so when you talk to someone, you need to understand their pain. You need to grab them. You need to give it to them. I understand your concerns. I hear you. I see you. I appreciate you, right?
Right.
And then this is the pain part. And then the pleasure is that compelling feature. Okay, so now we're here. Let's talk about how we can move forward.
Sorry to interrupt you here with that. What you just said is really, I mean, that's sales philosophy. When you're going out to sell, I mean, you really can't sell unless you understand their condition, you make the acknowledgement, and then you show them how you're going to be the solution to their problems. So it's amazing to me as I hear that how much crossover there is, and that's exactly why I wanted to make sure that you were here in Shark Bite Biz.
See, that's exactly why I'm saying NLP is not something that you actually discover.
Right.
You like remember, oh, that's exactly what I'm doing. Yeah. If you're doing that already, you're a master, my friend. Because that's what we need. Like at the really core of being human, that's what we need. And that's why I'm very passionate about it. I mean, I blend
NLP
with 9 other things in my NeuroShine technology, and I love it.
You're extremely passionate. and your NeuroShine technology is also basic. So let me ask you something a little different. Hopefully this doesn't put you too much on the spot, but how does your NeuroShine technology, your version of things, differ from maybe what like Tony Robbins does or some of the other people out there with NLP? Because yours is different, not just a carbon copy of what Tony Robbins does, correct?
Well, yes. Tony Robbins actually used NLP, and then he created his own methodology too. He doesn't mention about it, but he named it neuroassociative conditioning. Okay. He had his own stuff, but he didn't really go after it. Right. But when I learned NLP, it has always been my compelling future vision to create my own. I'm an innovator, okay? Yeah. So I got to create.
Oh, and
as you see, I don't know if the audience is also going to see, as you see the diplomas on my wall, I'm a professional student.
I just looked. We can see it. Yeah. Then that's a massive, massive supply. If you let me point this out for all the people that are listening on iTunes, Spotify, Google Podcasts, she has about 40 different diplomas on her wall. It's really massive. I have a diploma. I have what? 3 diplomas behind me, and she just put me to shame.
Because I love education, and that's what makes me different. You know, as I have been telling you, well, I'm a social scientist, okay? Mm-hmm. So I consider myself a social scientist, and when I approach a methodology like NLP, I gotta understand it to the core of it.
Right.
And I need to study the science behind it. That's why I studied neuroscience, and I studied heart science. And that's why I decided to combine the two. NLP approaches human being only through the mind.
Right.
My NeuroShine technology, like I introduced at the beginning, it's the combine the power of the mind and then the wisdom of the heart. And then you will find your truth.
Yeah.
When I started studying NLP, it was only the mind, right? The power of the mind, how the mind works and what it does and yada, yada. And then I found myself studying so many other things and even quantum physics and cosmology and metaphysics, because quantum physics is about the quanta, the photons, and what we are all energy. And metaphysics is what is beyond physics, like what is even intangible.
Right.
And when I studied heart science, I just realized something. Wow, that actually makes a lot of sense, because a lot of people, when I coach them, like executives, mostly executives, I do executive coaching, right?
Right.
So when I coach them, what I mostly find out is that they are so stuck in the mind.
Right.
And when you're so stuck in the mind, then you won't be able to find the solution. Because why? You need to drop to the heart.
Mm-hmm.
Heart has so many civilizations of wisdom, and it carries a lot of intuition. And when you are just stressed out, you need to take a nice deep breath and drop it to the heart. And heart is going to send a lot of information to the brain. Did you know, David, that the heart sends much more information to the brain than the brain does send to the heart?
Wow, that's amazing. I had never known that. Why is that, though?
Well, because the heart has its own system around and its own neurons. It's called neurites. There are neurites around the heart, and then they actually send a lot of information to all parts of the brain, to all parts of the body, but mostly to the brain, because those neurites, they carry information that even creates those, you know, we sometimes say, oh, the chatter, the monkey chatter, the brain, we hear a lot of noises in the mind, the voices.
Mm-hmm.
They're mostly coming from the heart.
Wow.
It's crazy we don't know about the heart. And that's why it's a very long answer to your question. My NeuroShine technology has 10 different disciplines in it. Not only mind, not only NLP. NLP is the foundation, because that's the first thing that I studied and I became a trainer for. But and then I studied so many other disciplines, and that's why I have so many certifications and diplomas on my wall. And I integrated them. I love integration. And when I integrated them, I see the system. Like how, when you go to work, when you talk to your colleagues, or when you do a sales conversation with someone, What goes to that conversation is the system of who you are. And it comes with the brain, it comes with the heart, and it comes with your energy centers, even your chakras. It's a whole system, and we need to understand that. And that is why NeuroShine technology is different from NLP or any other stuff.
Yeah, no, that was an amazing, great answer. One of the first things you kicked off with, well, first off, I've got to say, I'm not even going to take any more college courses now. I'm just going to start hanging out with you because you're just a wealth of knowledge. I'll learn everything from anatomy to science, quantum physics. I'm just going to hang out with Shiny.
But, yes,
but you know, the very first phrase that you said with your answer was about education and just loving to learn. That is the exact reason why I started Shark Bite Biz, is because I knew that I'm very advanced. I know a lot of things. I've been very successful, sales, business strategy, all that good stuff. What I wanted to do was I still want to get to the next level. And the only way I could do that is by talking with people, experts like you, pinging their minds. And I figured, hey, you know what? If I'm going to do that, why don't I just make a podcast about it and get it out there and allow thousands, hopefully hundreds of thousands of people to come on this journey with me. But it's only possible because of people like you coming on to Shark Bite Biz, Shidey.
So, I'm happy to be here.
Thank you. So we do got to get wrapped up. Do you have anything else? If there's one thing that you would want our listeners, whether wherever they are, to take out of this conversation, what's the one key point?
Truth will make you shine.
Truth will make you shine. that's amazing. There you go. You heard it from Shiny herself.
That is really the whole point, because when I talk about NeuroShine technology, the way I positioned it, it is the technology for truth and a system for enlightenment.
Yes.
Because I know when I unload and unlearn all of the conditioning from my childhood that doesn't belong to me, I can find the true me. And then with that true me, I'm going to shine even more. Because it's going to be my choices, my goals, my life, the way exactly how I want to live it. If everybody can live
their
life on their own terms, then this world is going to be a much better place.
Better place. Totally, totally agree with that. So let me ask you, Shiny, you have a book out, you have courses. Why don't you give us a plug right here? Tell our listeners and those watching on YouTube, how can they reach you and where can they find your stuff?
Well, I have a website with my name and last name, shinyunsal.com.
Can you spell Unsal for the audio listeners?
S-H-I-N-Y-U-N-S-A-L.
Perfect. .com. Yes.
Okay. So in my, like, it's the same, by the way, for social media. Like I'm on LinkedIn, on Instagram, everywhere, Facebook. And when they go to my website, they will see different things that I provide. With my NeuroShine technology, I created a book. I created online courses, trainings. I have my own YouTube show and my podcast as well. So I have not started the interviews yet, but when I do, I'll make sure you're on it.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you.
And if they ever want to learn NLP, they can simply go to shinyunsal.com/NLP.
Okay.
And they can actually sign up and start learning NLP from my digital courses. You know, during the lockdown, I took the time to be productive and I reproduced a ton of videos. And those courses, they come with, for the podcast listeners, if they want audio, they have audio files, and I created PDF worksheets, and they can study, they can learn at their own pace, and then they will have, you know, a lifetime access to all the programs that I created, and I am really proud of them. So they should definitely check it out.
Yeah, I totally agree. I was looking here. I didn't mean to look distracted, but I was looking because I actually have a copy of your book, but then I saw it. It's all the way up on my shelf up there. I was going to show everybody. It is, there it is. It is an amazing, amazing book. And hey, Shiny, thank you so much for being on for Shark Bite Biz. I'll definitely make sure that we re-invite you back on in a couple months to give us some more updates.
Yeah, I'm just getting started. You know me. I mean,
you're just getting started?
Well, certainly a warm-up. Yeah. So thanks for having me, and congratulations with this amazing podcast. Again, this is a great venture, and I am looking forward to be back again.
Okay, thank you. Take care of the shiny one. Bye.
Okay, I sure will. And remember, everyone, truth will make you shine. Bye-bye.
Bye. Shiny is so fun, isn't she? Always an enlightening conversation with her. I think some people just naturally have NLP-type skills ingrained into them. I feel that it really comes naturally to a lot of people, but taking advantage of somebody like Shiny can really help you polish that up and make you shine like a diamond. Okay, enough with the puns. Unlocking your mind and how you think is an extremely powerful tool. Like Shiny said, recognize and understand their pain, listening to your customer, unlocking your mind and how you think is an extremely powerful tool. Like Shiny said, recognize and understand their pain. Listen to your customer. At the core of each human being, we really want understanding. Using tools like NLP, and again, you probably already do in some format, can really help you achieve that. It comes down to, once you understand how your mind works, the mechanics of the mind, and ultimately, what you're doing is unlocking the decision-making power in your customer. Sales reps are usually not known as being great listeners because they love to talk. That's why I'm a podcast host. But this is a great tool in order to help you learn how to listen. You know, there's an old story back there that says that we were born with 2 ears and 1 mouth for a reason, and we must not forget to use them proportionately. So let me ask you, do you use NLP? Have you ever heard of it? Does it work for you? Come on, YouTubers, leave a comment down below and let's discuss. I want to hear what everybody thinks about this topic. Do you buy into it? Do you understand it? Does it work? Let's get the discussion going. Also, I got a little bit of an announcement to make. This channel is starting to take off. I believe right now we're early in, just going into our fourth week with episode 7. We have over 1,200 subscribers. That's in about 22 or 23 days. That's amazing. You guys are all doing awesome. So we're doing so well. I've made some decisions that we want to start doing some upgrades in our equipment in order to give you higher quality content. Ultimately, we're streaming a lot of this stuff, the conversations over the internet. Everybody's working remotely. It's going to be hard to always have it perfect. You're always going to have little nuances, but we're working harder to get everything even better than what it already is. Regardless, we're off to an amazing start. And in a couple episodes, you're going to start seeing some even higher quality interviews. If you like the content that you're listening, though, please let me know that. Let us know that at Shark Bite Biz. So please, if you're watching on YouTube channel, please subscribe. If you're on Spotify, iTunes, Google Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Pandora, Stitcher, wherever you are, please make sure you subscribe so that way you always get the most up-to-date episode. Let us know that you like the content that we're coming out with. Thank you so much, and I really look forward to seeing you all in the next episode. Cheers.
Thank you for listening to Shark Bite Biz. We hope you got some insightful info from this podcast. Be sure to subscribe to us through your favorite podcast app and visit us on the web at www.sharkbitebiz.com. How has business changed for you in the 20s? Email us at podcast@sharkbitebiz.com so you can join us and share your story.